Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me help you pick out an external display for your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So there are many reasons you may want an external display for your Mac. A Mac Mini or a Mac Pro, of course, needs an external display. If you have a MacBook, then you may want to place it at your desk and have an external display as either your second screen or your primary screen. And for an iMac, you may simply want to have a second display. And having a second display can really enhance your Mac. It can double the amount of space that you've got to move things around on the desktop and work with Windows. Now, Apple only has one external display that they sell. That's the very expensive professional model. So most likely you're in the market for a much cheaper but pretty good quality display that you can buy at an electronics store or online at places like Amazon or just about anywhere. There are many different factors that you need to consider. For instance, there's physical size, how big the display is, but also the resolution, which is not necessarily related to physical size. Just having a larger screen doesn't mean you have more pixels. And then there's also the connection type. Cheaper screens may only have HDMI, which is primarily used for TVs, and then require an adapter to go from your Mac to the screen. Also, some of the more advanced screens will have power through their connection. So if you have a MacBook, you can plug it into the screen and not only will it act as an external display to your MacBook, but also provide power so you don't have to plug it in addition to connecting it to your display. Some screens also act as a USB dock, so you can plug in other USB devices into the screen, and then when you connect your MacBook to the screen, you see those extra devices just like they were plugged in directly to your Mac. So say you could have a printer plugged into the screen, and then when you plug into the screen, you not only get the display, but the printer as well. Some screens have speakers. Now, this will be very important, say if you have a Mac Mini, which doesn't really have real speakers. So with the screen connected, not only do you have the visual part of the screen, but also now you get stereo speakers. But if you're using it as a second display for an iMac, then you really don't need that. Or maybe you're just using a set of external speakers anyway, so you're not going to use the ones that are in the screen. Then of course there's quality. You want to make sure you get something that's going to last, something that also is going to be nice and bright and is going to show good colors and things like that. And of course the one factor that ties into the rest of them is price. You have to spend more to get higher quality and to get better features. So you have to kind of look at your budget and decide what it is you can afford. So first let's talk about size. So there are three main sizes that you'll find when looking for screens. 24-inch, 27-inch, and 32-inch. There are other sizes as well, and sometimes 27-inch screens are called 28-inch screens and things like that. But basically most screens are going to fall into those three sizes. So here's a 24-inch screen. Of course I'm using American measurements here. And note that these measurements are from one corner to the other. So it's not the width or height, it's the diagonal measurement. And you can see if you go to a 27-inch screen, it looks a little bit bigger. It actually is a lot bigger because, of course, you're getting the area, not the width and height. And then if you go to 32-inch, it's even much bigger than that. If you can, get to a computer store that sells screens at some point and look at the different sizes and get an idea of what these are. 24-inch really seems quite small. 27-inch kind of seems normal. 32-inch seems quite large. So you probably don't want to buy these blind. You want to actually see these screens, even if they're not the exact models you're looking at least see the sizes so you get an idea of what it is you have space for and what you want. Now resolution of the screen is a different matter. Now a while ago, most screens would have been about 1920 by 1080. This is sometimes just called HD or 1080p. And what you get here are basically 2 million pixels. Now, years ago, Apple introduced what they call retina displays. And that's where there are 4 pixels, a square of 4 pixels, where there used to just be one. So the screen sizes are the same, but you have more pixels, twice as many wide and twice as many high. So when you go from 1920 by 1080 to 3840 by 2160, notice the number of pixels goes up 4 times. So now you have more than 8 million pixels. This is quite an improvement and quite a difference. Pictures will display using all of these extra pixels. So they're going to look a lot closer to, say, a printed photo than with a 1080 screen. And text will look a lot clearer. It's hard to illustrate, but if you look, say, under a magnifying glass at text on a 1080 screen, you may see something like this. Now, of course, shrunk down, your eye is just going to see the word. But Here's what it looks like on a Retina display, also called UHD for ultra high definition. And you can see that there are a lot more pixels here. This is going to look a lot smoother to your eye at the regular size. So even while at first it may not seem like there's that much of a difference, I mean you could read the words in either case, it's going to mean that the text looks a lot smoother. It's going to have a lot less eye strain. It's going to look a lot better. Now all new Macs, the MacBooks, the iMacs, they come with a Retina display. So you're going to see the equivalent to a UHD screen. So if you want the real Mac experience, don't bother with the standard definition screens anymore. Only look for UHD or Retina displays. Now another thing to consider is the connection. So on your Mac you have one of four different kinds of connections. And you can see those here on the left. You've got HDMI available on some older Macs but none of the current ones. On older Macs also you're going to have ports that look the same but they're slightly different. Very older Macs are going to have mini DisplayPort ports. And newer Macs will have Thunderbolt 2. They look the same and indeed Thunderbolt 2 can carry mini DisplayPort. So if you have either one of these two, all you need is a mini DisplayPort cable. It doesn't matter if Thunderbolt 2 or an older mini DisplayPort. And then you can go from there to your screen. Now all current Macs have USB-C, also known as Thunderbolt 3. This also includes mini DisplayPort. So you can connect a mini DisplayPort cable to this USB-C Thunderbolt 3 port. Of course it has to match the physical type of USB-C. So it's a different kind of cable. But going from USB-C Thunderbolt 3 to a screen that has mini DisplayPort is a direct connection. Your Mac is actually sending mini DisplayPort signals out right to the screen. Now on the right you'll see what screens have. Just about any screen you find now is going to at least have HDMI. But if that's all it's got, it's probably not a great match for your Mac. A lot of screens will have mini DisplayPort or DisplayPort. And I don't have a symbol for it here, but it's a larger port. It's the same thing as mini DisplayPort. It carries the same information, but it's a different shape. And a lot of times when you get a screen that has the older full-size mini DisplayPort, it also comes with a cable that goes from the full-size DisplayPort to mini DisplayPort at the other end. And then newer screens will also have USB-C. So let's take a look at some combinations here. If you've got a Mac with HDMI, and you go to a screen with HDMI, you can go directly with just a simple HDMI connector. Now, if you've got something that's got USB-C, like a newer Mac, or even an older Mac with Thunderbolt 2, then you can get a cable that goes from those to the HDMI port on a screen. However, I put X's through this because you shouldn't do that. Now, it technically works. And on some screens, it may work just as well as anything else. But on other screens, it's not going to work well at all. Time and time again, people have asked me about problems they're having with their external screen, and I find out they're going from either USB-C or Thunderbolt 2 to HDMI on the screen, even though the screen has a DisplayPort or mini DisplayPort port on the back. Just go directly from the mini DisplayPort or Thunderbolt to the DisplayPort port on the back. Keeping it all in DisplayPort, that's kind of the computer language of talking to a screen. That always gets you the best results on the Mac. Trying to go to HDMI just because you happen to see HDMI on the back, that could often lead to problems. And only use HDMI if that's the only possible way to connect with the screen. And of course, avoid any screen that only has HDMI. Go for at least something that has DisplayPort or mini DisplayPort on the back. Now you can also, of course, go from a USB-C Thunderbolt 3 port on all of the current Macs to either a DisplayPort on the back of your screen, which is great, will work just fine. But if you're going directly to a USB-C port that some of these have, then you're going to get some extra benefits. For instance, that may also carry a USB signal, which means that if there are USB ports on the back of the screen, you can use the screen as a hub, as a dock, in other words. So you can connect other things to it. And then also you get some other things, like if there's speakers, then those speakers would show up on your Mac with just that one cable. In addition, you can often get power this way. So if the screen supports it, it will send power back to your MacBook. So this is only important, of course, if you have a MacBook. If you have an iMac and this is the second display, it doesn't matter. But for a MacBook, you can connect one cable if you go from the Thunderbolt 3 port on your MacBook to a USB-C Thunderbolt 3 port on the screen. And you'll get power back to your MacBook and also usually get other USB connections that are on the back of the screen. So it acts as a dock as well. And even speakers too. So one cable can carry just about everything that you need. So let's look at some examples. Here is a very inexpensive Acer display. You can see it's under $30. It is a 24-inch screen, so it's a very small screen compared to everything else, and it's 1920 by 1080, so it's a 1080 screen. So you're getting a good price on this. It's pretty cheap and hard to argue with how cheap it is, but you're not going to really get the full potential of your Mac with something at standard resolution, and it's going to be pretty small as well. If we look at the back here, we could see that it has basically some older type connections and an HDMI connection. So you're going to need to get a mini display port or Thunderbolt or USB-C to HDMI cable, which is going to cost a little bit, and then that's all you're going to be able to use to connect to the screen. It'll be fine because the screen's so low resolution, it's really not going to matter. So this is an example of one of the cheapest ways to connect. But if you're spending the money to get a Mac, then at least spend a little more money to get a decent screen. So here's a Samsung screen that is 27 inches, so much more normal size, but it's still 1080. So you're still going to get that standard resolution. It's a little more expensive for the larger size, and it's better quality. And also notice that in addition to HDMI, it has DisplayPort. So you can connect directly from a mini DisplayPort, Thunderbolt 2 or Thunderbolt 3 port with the right cable directly to this, and you'll get good results. But you're still at 1080p. It also works as a USB hub, so you can connect a USB cable to it, and now you've got some extra USB ports. But it carries no power here, so you're going to have to also plug in your MacBook if that's what you're using with this. Of course, if it's Mac Mini or iMac, that doesn't matter. So this is a better option for a little more money, but it still doesn't get you the really good resolution that you should be using with your Mac. So here's another option, and this one is definitely more expensive, but you're getting UHD. So you're getting the equivalent to Apple's Retina displays. So you can see here it's 3840 by 2160. It also has a USB Type-C connection. So you'll be able to plug that cable directly into, say, a MacBook. And if you look down here at some of the specifications, you'll see it delivers 60 watts of power. So you want to check that against whatever you've got. So for instance, if you have a MacBook Air and you look at the tech specs for a MacBook Air, you'll see that under battery and power, it comes with a 30 watt power adapter. So certainly the 60 watts delivered here is going to be more than enough. And even if the power adapter is a little bit more, like the MacBook Pro is 61 watts, 60 watts will be fine to fully power the MacBook Pro. So you'll be able to connect your MacBook with one cable and get the screen and power at the same time. So those are just some examples. Models switch out all the time. So perhaps by the time you see this, there'll already be different model numbers and all of that. So you just have to search for different displays, read the specs. It can be confusing. There can be a lot of different ones to look through. So it takes a little bit of patience to find exactly the one that fits your needs. So here are my recommendations for all the things I talked about at the beginning here. So for physical size, I wouldn't consider a 24-inch one unless you have a really good reason that you want a tiny screen. Go with 27-inch for standard size or 32-inch if you want something even larger. Then for resolution, don't mess with anything less than 4K. There are screens that are 5K and even higher nowadays, but they're going to cost a lot more. 4K is kind of the standard at the moment, so look for 3840 by 2160 for a screen. Connection type, always go with the screen that has DisplayPort for standard screens, like adding a second screen to your iMac or connecting something to your Mac Mini. But if you're connecting a MacBook, make sure you're getting power back through the connection, which is usually specified as USB-C or Thunderbolt 3. As for whether it's a USB dock, it's probably not that important. I mean, usually there are not too many USB ports on any of these. So if you have a lot of external devices, you're going to get a USB hub and they're pretty cheap anyway. But if it's something you want, take a look at that. And speakers, really only if needed. It's easy to get external speakers, which are probably always going to be better than any built into a screen. But if speakers aren't that important to you, but you still kind of need them, you know, to watch videos and things, then that may be something you want to look for. How about quality? People always ask me about brands. And of course, I only have experience with the brands I've used in the past. And I can tell you that LG makes pretty good screens, so does Samsung, and so does Dell. As a matter of fact, a lot of the screens actually have some of the same internal parts. I know Samsung makes a lot of the displays that Apple's used over the years, and LG's probably putting some of those same displays into theirs. There are other brands as well, but I've never really used them, and I don't really consider them when I'm shopping for a screen. So if you're looking for brands, those are the three that I could say are usually pretty good, but it doesn't mean that the other ones are necessarily bad. And price is really subjective. For some people, spending $1,500 for a really good screen because they do graphics work. It's totally worth it and easy to justify because they make money using their Macs. For other people, they want to spend as little as possible and stick to $400 or less. Another thing I would suggest is make sure it's pretty easy to return a screen in case you get it and something's wrong with it. Because I'd say 95% of the time everything's fine, but it's a pretty high error rate for getting screens with dead pixels, or maybe they don't work quite right with your model of Mac. So you want to make sure it's easy to just bring it back so you can try another one. So if it's a local store, ask them if it's easy to return, just bring it right back to them. Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. And if it's an online store, make sure it's really easy to take it somewhere to return it, because of course shipping a screen back can be a real hassle because they're so large. So if you're in the market for a screen for your Mac, I hope this helps you pick one out. If you have any questions, ask them in the comments below. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.